Yo, what's good, YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ. And make sure you hit that like button. We are here for the start of this San Jose State dynasty here on the channel. And this is going to be quite the rebuild. We're starting out this offense with the 61 overall. And that's probably contributed to a lot of young guys on offense. We have the quarterback battle that's going to happen in this game. Josh Love and Montel Aaron. And then we have a couple of receivers who are young. They're coming up. But our defense is kind of the veteran part of our team. We have a lot of graduating seniors, and that's why we're rated better on defense at 65. But I imagine that being flipped around come next season. So we're probably going to be better on offense next season and worse on defense. So we are starting out this game on the blue squad, led by the junior Josh Love at quarterback. And we are going first team offense versus second team defense. In the second half, we'll control the white team. But in this first half, we'll control the blue team. So we're starting out this game right away with the Cameron Alexander sack. But look at him. He is 6'5", 280 as a sophomore. He is going to be a beast in the future. So now on a second and 14, here is Josh Love throwing out to the right side. That's Ty Cottrell. And he's picking up 24 yards on the reception. You can see him. He's 5'7", 175. 91 speed. He is also our kick returner and punt returner, so he's going to be looking to get the ball in space and get that. Some plays on offense. So now here on the next pass, here is a pick by James Will Smith, and he's going to take this one all the way to the house. And this is a familiar face. He is a transfer from Coastal Carolina in our last dynasty, and he's coming over as a freshman. And look at this. I mean, he's not the best rated safety on the squad by any means, but he's got a lot of potential in the future, and already he picks off Josh Love. So here is Tyler Nevins getting the handoff up the middle of the sophomore running back as he picks up 2 yards. So now third and eight, here's Josh Love finally getting a good throw that time to Bailey Gaither, who's actually I'm predicting to be our best receiver and lead our team in receiving yards. I would say he comes in at 69 overall, but he's just a solid guy. I could see him doing big things this season. But now on a fourth, third down, we get sacked. And that's Caleb Oaks. Caleb Oaks is another transfer from Coastal Carolina. Only comes in at 63 overall, but he's a sophomore, so he's got some room to grow. And he's actually right now slated on the second spot in our depth chart at defensive tackle. But he's on the second team defense just to get him some first team reps at D tackle. So here's Malik Roberson. He's a senior running back, 88 speed, 88 excel, 88 agility. He's pretty solid, I'd say. But as a senior, he's going to be hard to replace because we do have a two running back system. But it's going to be tough because we got to recruit some of these guys and replace some of these senior guys on the squad. So now on a third and 15, throwing the ball deep is Montel Aaron. He's finding Trey Walker, a true sophomore, 5'11", 160. And he doesn't do anything great. But he's a young guy, so I think he's going to grow quite a bit. So here's Montel Aaron running an option this time and picking up a lot of room up the middle. And he's picking up 20 yards. So here's Montel Aaron, 69 overall, 73 speed, 81 throw power, 75 throw accuracy. It's going to be a battle between him and Josh Love. We'll see who performs the better with the better stats in this game and leads our team to victory in this one. So here is Montel Aaron taking the read option to the left side, and he's picking up the first down. Montel Aaron is looking pretty impressive on that drive, and Josh Love has definitely got some competition now. So here comes Josh Love back out onto the field, rolling out to the right side, gonna throw the screen late to Bailey Gaither and pick up only 4 yards on that one. So now second and six, here is Josh Love rolling out to the right side once again. He's got the wheels. Out of those two, he can run the best as he picks up 8 yards on that one. And I think that's the advantage that Josh Love has over Montel Aaron. He can run the ball, but his throwing isn't the best. But on the next play, a toss play out to Tyler Nevins, and he's going to cough this one up. But look who it is. It's Caleb Oaks, the transfer from Coastal. He forces the fumble, and now Montel Aaron gets another shot at a short drive. So here is Roberson once more on the handoff, getting 6 yards on that one after the turnover. So now second and four, here's Roberson again picking up another gain of 5 and moving the ball close to the 20-yard line. So first and 10, here's Montel Aaron throwing the ball to the right side, and that's going to be caught by Rashad Johnson for the 19-yard reception. He's a senior redshirt, and we do have a few seniors on the offense, but not a ton, but we do have some key seniors, Ty Cottrell and Malik Roberson probably being the biggest ones on the offense, but we have some work to do as far as rebuilding this defense and offense. So here is Isaac Taguia. He got this tackle on that one, but you can see he's in a battle for that right outside linebacker position. There's a lot of guys kind of clumped together with kind of the same overall, so I'm really looking for a guy that can really just show he can play better on the field than his ratings. I mean, that's the thing about NCAA football. People play better than their ratings, and we'll have to see who plays well in this one. But on that drop on the next possession, Josh Oliver, a senior tight end, he's one of the seniors that we will have to replace on this offense, but he drops that one, and he gives them another opportunity for another stop. So now on a third down, throwing out to the right side, and that's Taguia on the deflection, and that's going to be a punt for this blue team. So the blue team has not put together a good drive yet, and that's the first team offense. If we can't score versus the second team defense, we're going to be in trouble this season. So here's Malik Roberson getting the hand up the middle for 6 yards as he picks up another first down. So now third and 6. Here is Montel Aaron from the shotgun throwing out to the middle of the field, and that's Holmes on that one. Justin Holmes for 29 yards up the middle for the touchdown. And Justin Holmes, another receiver that's a senior on this team. I mean, that's the position that we're going to have to kind of rebuild, because like I said, we're young on offense, but that's only counting our quarterbacks who are juniors and sophomores. But then we have our Tyler Nevins, who's actually a sophomore as well. You can see here, a sophomore, 88 speed, 88 acceleration, and he's kind of the same mold as Roberson, as you can see there. So now on a third and 2, here is Josh Love throwing out to the left side. That's caught by the senior Josh Oliver, and that's a gain of 6 on that one. So now second and 10, here's Josh Love throwing across the middle, and that's Hartley on this one, and Trey Hartley puts on a move and gets into the open field, and that's a gain of almost 50. Another senior receiver on this team. I said our offense was young, but we do have to depend on a lot of guys on this offense to develop behind these seniors. But man, we have a ton of them at receiver. So now here's Josh Love from under center tossing the ball out to Tyler Nevins, the sophomore, and getting in for the touchdown. So he finally completes a nice drive, and he finally gets on the board, making it 24-7 with the white team leading this one. So now here's Montel Aaron running the option and picking up a first down. It's kind of surprising. He's running the option, and he's not the most mobile guy. I definitely want to depend on his arm a little bit more than Josh Love's, but he's showing that he can run the option. So here's Roberson on the handoff once more and picking up 11 yards, and he's getting a first down past the 50-yard line. So here is Montel Aaron once again handing it off to Roberson, and Roberson cannot be stopped so far in this game, and he is tackled by Ziegler on that one, and he picks up the first down. That's actually Dakari Monroe, my mistake. So now here is Justin Holmes getting another 7-yard reception, and wow, they are moving the ball with Montel Aaron at quarterback. But here on the next play, giving it up the middle, and that's actually going to be a stop by Taguia, who's actually impressive. He's a true freshman, and he's impressive. So here is Roberson on the draw play, and he's picking up 16 yards, and he sets them up for a third and goal. Hand off up the middle, and there is a stop by a guy that we haven't heard his name yet, Jesse Osuna. And he's actually 67 overall, and he's going to be looking to wreak havoc in this game. So now here's Kasiri Robinson getting the handoff up the middle, and he picks up the touchdown. And Kasiri Robinson is one of our young guys on offense. A true freshman, 5'8", 180. He's going to be a problem for defenses in the future. I'm hoping that I can redshirt him and he can grow behind these veteran running backs. So here's Ty Cottrell getting the long return on this one and getting to the 35-yard line. This is one of the things that, you know, we kind of preached as far as getting this guy involved in the offense, Ty Cottrell. And speaking of getting guys involved in the offense, this is exactly what I expect from Josh Love. He keeps that ball on the option and picks up 29 yards. And this is what I thought he would do, and Montel Aaron would be the one that's passing the ball. But so far, Montel Aaron is showing that he can run the option. But here is Tyler Nevins getting in for the blue team. And he's making it a 14-31 lead here as the white team comes back out with under 2 minutes left in this half. But here we're sending some pressure this time, and that's a sack. So Montel Aaron is going to get sacked, and that's a nice sack on the outside, sending Jesse Ozuna in, and we pick up the sack on that. So now 3rd and 14. Here is Montel Aaron from the shotgun. Look at the pressure. I like the pressure up the middle, making Montel Aaron move in the pocket, and he throws short for 2 yards and another punt here in this game. So now here, a minute left in this half, and here's Josh Love throwing on the run. He's got to make that throw. Maybe Ty Cottrell could have reached out for that one, but that throw's got to be on the money. So here's Josh Love rolling out to the right side once again, but this time he's going to find Bailey Gaither on the sideline for 13 yards. So now 50 seconds left in this half. 1st and 10. Getting hit on this throw, but throwing the ball deep, and that's Bailey Gaither. Touchdown for the blue team, and that's the type of throw I expect a starter to make, and that's the type of throw that can win you a job, as that's a beautiful, beautiful deep throw. So we do go into halftime here, 31-21, and this game is going to get interesting. So here in the second half, we're going to take a look at some other guys too. And we haven't taken a look at our 3rd and 4th string running back, quarterbacks actually, and also our running backs. So we'll get a chance to look at them a little bit. But I liked what I saw from the white team. The white team really impressed me on offense with Roberson the senior and Montel Aaron at quarterback. So we are controlling the white team here in the second half. There is Isaac Togia. I mean, that guy is impressive so far in this game in coverage. And we throw the incomplete pass. So now here's Montel Aaron rolling out to the left side, this time using his legs, picking up a few yards, 5 yards, but the blue team and that first team offense does force a punt once again. So now here's the blue team back out onto the field. There's Ty Cottrell getting the 5-yard reception thrown from Josh Love, as that's a gain of 5. So here's Josh Love from under center throwing the ball to the right side, and finally Josh Oliver gets involved in this game, 26 yards on that one, as he's got 3 receptions for 65 yards, but it's been a quiet 65 as he moves the ball for a first down. So here's Bailey Gaither, who I said was going to be probably our leading receiver this season. He looks impressive in this game as he goes over 100 yards with that catch. So here's Josh Love once again from the shotgun, throwing the ball out to the right side, and that's Josh Oliver, another 14-yard reception on this one. So now here's Josh Love under center, giving the ball to Tyler Nevins. And Tyler Nevins, he hits the hole with a lot of burst, along with Roberson. I like these guys. Nevins is the bigger back, but I like that Roberson is also small. He can fit through a lot of holes, and he's going to be kind of the scat back in this offense. So now here's Josh Love here from under center, rolling out to the right side, and nobody's going to be home to catch him. And that's a 5-yard touchdown run, and he's kind of brought it together a little bit. Put together that nice drive, and he picks up the touchdown. So here is Montel Aaron throwing the ball across the middle in coverage, and that's incomplete, as that's pretty nice coverage by Ziegler on that one. I like the coverage I see from these cornerbacks. They're playing a pretty good game as we get it down to a 2nd and 10. Here's Montel Aaron from the shotgun running the screen pass, and this time Roberson's going to get out of there. He's going to pick up 11 yards on that one, and that's going to be enough for a first down. So here's Montel Aaron running Justin Holmes in motion, the senior, and he's picking up a lot of room. He's got to move to the inside. He makes it, and he gets a nice 20-yard gain on that one. So now we move inside the 30-yard line as Justin Holmes, another one of these guys that I think is going to be like a gadget receiver, him and also Ty Cottrell, but they're both seniors, so I'm going to need to replace both of them. So here is the sophomore Trey Walker getting involved, and he's getting a 9-yard reception on that one. 5 receptions for 70 yards. He's been pretty impressive so far. So here's Kasiri Robinson getting the handoff up the middle, and that's the freshman who's probably slated to be our future at running back. So now on a 2nd and goal, here is Malik Roberson this time, breaking a tackle, getting in for the 3-yard touchdown reception. And that is a nice drive put together by Montel Aaron. What an impressive showing from Montel Aaron. 15 for 22, 2 touchdowns. I really like what I see from this kid. He's only a sophomore. So now here's Rico Tolfrey on the tackle there as they lose one, the blue team. So now here on a draw play, here's Tyler Nevins getting to the outside on a 2nd and 11, and he's picking up a nice gain on that one. And that is another first down for the blue team. So here is Josh Love once again handing it off to Tyler Nevins. Tyler Nevins showing that vision and showing the ability to fight for extra yards. That's a gain of 25 on that one. So now here's Josh Love with this blue team. Now at the 35-yard line, and he's going to throw out to the left side, but that's going to be tipped. And that's actually not Josh Love. That's Michael Carrillo. And let's look at Michael Carrillo. He's a senior, 5'11", 195, but he's just not probably in the conversation for starter. He's got a lot of room to grow, but as a senior, I can't see him getting much playing time at all. So now on a 2nd and 10, great blocking on this one, but thrown out to the left side. That's picked off by Bobby Brown, the second. And he's a sophomore here on the defense, and that's 3 turnovers for the blue team. And I just want to take a look at some of these safeties, man. Bobby Brown is a nice, nice guy at safety. And we have a slew of sophomore safeties. We have a couple of juniors, but our safeties are pretty young. And that's kind of different from the rest of our team because we have 3 seniors at cornerback. We have a senior at right end who is actually our best guy on the squad, Bryson Bridges. And we kind of got to get together with this defense because, you know, we're giving up a lot of big plays on both sides of the ball. And it's 38-28. We definitely want to be good defensively, especially going into conference play and a lot of our non-conference games. We got a lot of tough matchups, so we're going to need to settle it down, figure out who can do what. But you can see another guy that I want to highlight here, Tyson Parker, a sophomore left outside linebacker. I don't know if he's going to start because there are other guys in front of him, but as a sophomore, he's got a lot of potential as he gets in for the sack on that one. So here we get to see Carter back out onto the field as well for the white team, and then Carrillo out for the blue team. They're kind of 3rd and 4th on the depth chart. Carter is a freshman, so he does have time to develop, but he's always going to be probably sitting behind Montel Aaron. So I don't really know the potential with him, but I imagine him being a pretty good player down the road if he does get any playing time. So now on a 3rd and 2, here's Packer, Dijon Packer, and he's going to get tackled by James Will Smith, and he's the freshman coming over from Coastal, and he's going to be looking to probably be the future at safety. A lot of the safeties that we do have on our squad, I did not mention this, but they're really close in overall, so I could imagine a lot of battles in the future. So here's Bailey Gaither getting the reception on the left side. He's picking up 15 on that one, and finally, I mean, getting some yardage here from Carrillo. So now here's a throw out to Josh Oliver, the starting tight end, and he's picking up 4 yards on that one. So here's Carrillo from the shotgun, almost into the red zone, throwing out to the left side. That's Ty Cottrell for 6 yards, breaking a couple of tackles, and that's exactly what I want to see out of him. So 2.5 minutes left here in this spring game. Here is Packer getting the handoff up the middle, and Dijon Packer is going to pick up the touchdown, and he is a senior at running back. He's a power back, and he's going to get in some power situations, but honestly, I just don't know the role that I'm going to have for him on this team. So here's Terrell Carter trying to scramble out, but this time taking a huge hit from Ethan Aguayo, who, I mean, pretty much having himself a pretty good game. So now on a 3rd and 6, here's a tip, and that's picked off by Lafu. And look at Lafu. I mean, he is a defensive end. He is our starter slated in there right now, but that's a pretty incredible interception as he has the awareness to keep his eyes up and catch the ball while it's still in the air. So now 1.5 minutes left in this half, in this game. Here's Josh Oliver getting a 5-yard reception on the outside, and that's going to bring it to a 3rd and 5. Here's Michael Carrillo trying to throw the screen pass. Another opportunity for interception on the screen, and that's going to be enough for them to settle for the field goal, making it a 38-38 game as we take this one into overtime. Remember, it's a spring game, so it doesn't count for anything. So, I mean, really, we're just trying to get some good looks for some guys and see what we got on the roster. So here's Malik Roberson getting the handoff up the middle, picking up a pretty good gain. Here's Kasiri Robinson, the freshman, who's likely going to get redshirted, but I can see him being a big part of this offense going into the future. So here is the blue team back out onto the field on Josh Love, throwing the ball to the left side. Look who it is. It's Cameron Smith this time. He's getting the interception, and he's going to take this one all the way back for the touchdown. What a way to end the spring game, but we definitely got a lot of good looks from both sides of the ball. I mean, a lot of guys showed up. I really liked the potential out of James Will Smith making that pick 6 to start the game. That was huge. And I like Isaac Taguia as well on defense. And obviously Caleb Oaks with the forced fumble and the sack to open the game. So looking at, you know, some of the stats for the blue team, Tyler Nevins had a pretty good game, 73 yards on the ground. I was really kind of impressed by Bailey Gaither. I mean, I knew he would be good, but he was a difference maker. If he can make differences like this in the game, when we go into actual gameplay, it's going to be pretty cool. So looking at the white team, looking at Montel Aaron, I mean, he was impressive. 16 for 23. Two touchdowns, only 148 yards passing, but honestly, the run game kind of carried him a little bit. Roberson had over 100 yards. Justin Holmes had a pretty good game from the slot as well. Trey Walker as well had a good game. But on the defensive end, look at James Will Smith. I mean, he's a freshman, but I mean, games like this, I mean, it makes me second guess whether to redshirt him, but I'm not going to be greedy because I know this is a rebuild. We're going to struggle out of the gate. We know that. And a lot of guys are going to need to get some playing time in order to kind of get the maximum potential out of this team. We want to kind of save kind of our freshmen. And I'm not going to redshirt any sophomores. It's only going to be freshmen. I'm going to keep this realistic. Remember, only freshmen are going to get redshirted, and that's the way we're going to keep it. But who impressed you the most this game? If you want to look at the roster a little bit, go into the last episode, check out the roster. But, you know, guys that – what I really care about is the quarterback battle. I mean, who won that? I mean, Montel Aaron, Josh Love. I think it's Montel Aaron. The running back battle, should Malik Roberson, the senior, get the nod at starter and then Tyler Nevins kind of be the compliment or what? And then at receiver, I mean, there was a ton of receivers in this game. Who do you guys think impressed the most? And I kind of showed some stats and some of the attributes of a lot of these guys, but let me know who you guys think was impressive. So hit subscribe, hit that like button. Make sure to hit that like button because we are here for the season opener next episode, so you don't want to miss that one. Stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go.